It's time for some Bring It Online questions from our chat room. What do you got?
This is from Joanne, who says, people say you get saved by having Jesus in your heart. My question is, don't you get saved by following the Ten Commandments and by faith?
It's by grace through faith. And that faith is in what Jesus did. If you start having faith in what you do, your faith is in the wrong thing. Is it good to follow the Ten Commandments? You bet. These are guidelines to keep us from bad things. It's not anything to keep us from something good. It says keep us from falling into trouble. But we all mess up, and we make mistakes. There isn't a one of us that hasn't missed the mark and fallen short. But God says, that's okay. I'll take care of that. I'll send Jesus, my only begotten Son. So all we have to do is have faith in him, that he lived a sinless life, and that he died on the cross, and that he rose again. And if we believe in him, then we'll have eternal life.
This is from Amber, who says, sometimes the Bible seems to contradict itself. If God established the law in the Old Testament, why would the law be considered bad in the New Testament? Why did God change his ways? How can we trust God when he changes his mind so much?
Well, he says, I am the Lord, I change not. The New Testament doesn't say the law is bad. It just says that the law prophesies of a Savior. God gave the law to Moses, the Torah to Moses, on the route to the promised land. And the problem was we can't live by those rules. We constantly are varying. We're the ones that vary. God laid out a path of salvation through the law. And then when we weren't able, he came through with his promise, which was made at the same time. Moses prophesied of Jesus. He says, there'll be somebody like me that comes. And that happened. So it's not a change. It's a time to rejoice that now we're no longer under the law of sin and death. We're under the law of grace and mercy. And when you understand that and the freedom that we have in Christ, it's truly liberating.
Okay, this is Nancy, who says, when I was younger, I had an affair and a baby out of wedlock. That child is now a 40-year-old schizophrenic. It's a daily torment to me. I asked God through the decades to forgive me, and I know he has. But why do I have to carry these consequences for the rest of my life?
Nancy, there's a tough one to answer in just a few seconds. I would encourage you to get some counseling and how can you effectively deal with your child. Are there consequences to sin? Yes, and that's obvious, and we have to live with those. And you're very tangibly living with that. But I would encourage you to reach out and see if there's a way that they're in your community, in your church, within the medical community where you are. You need to find some help and how to deal with your son.